Hey everyone, Nicola Light here, remembering you back into your own light. I wanted to come on today and do a video about the lower fourth dimension and issues that you might perceive to have during this process of moving through the lower fourth. Now, it's quite interesting actually that this information sort of come in many times, and I've done a couple of videos on it in the past, but it's just only recently we've working with some people during my sessions that we've sort of really sort of come into this understanding of the lower fourth and the movement through it, which has prevented them from seeing their light and ascending to such a degree with a sense of ease. And there's this sort of like a almost a feel of infiltration of their light as a result of moving through the lower fourth during their ascension process. So I want to sort of like tackle this information, and it may be a little bit sort of sticky for you to hold, and if it is, then just observe only and use your discernment to whether you want to continue to listen to me with regards to my truth from my perspective of experience. And then hopefully we're going to get some light language codes come in from my higher perspective of knowing, so that we can start to remember all of this information. This is not about knowledge. This is about the remembrance of who you are, deepening into you, really igniting your light and seeing who you are past the distortion of your beliefs and programming here on Earth. So let me start then by showing you a piece of paper, and I do apologize for not having my flip chart. It was sort of left in another location, and I can't access it at the moment, but so I've come to a simple pen and piece of paper. So here we have it. Hopefully that you'll see this without it shining too much on there, but if we could imagine then there are the three dimensions that we're going to be moving through. And if we sort of see that we have an awakening state, which we are in the third dimension. So we're at the third dimension. We're at the third dimension. I don't know if this is going to show up right on the screen, but there we go. Third dimension, might be backwards, might not be, but hopefully it'll be okay. But on the third dimension, we're moving through, we're just going through this solid rate of energy where we're in a bandwidth of energy. And as we move through, we're working through our five senses of reality, and we're bumbling along, doing our thing, deep into emotional states, perpetuating cycles and all that beautiful stuff that we go through. And during that time, as we start to rise in our vibration, as we start to rise up, we start then to move into the availability bandwidth of reaching into a fourth dimensional shift. And then as you rise through from the third dimensional shift, you move up into the fourth and then the fifth dimension. Now, these are bandwidths of consciousness connection. So you can rise to a certain point, but between them, there are these sticky patches of a rite of passage to say, are you ready to move through at soul level of understanding? But the fourth dimension, which is of the lower fourth dimension, is really, really quite sticky. And superimposed within that structure of that vibration, we start to open up into other realities, into other dimensions within that vibration, into that dimension, different realms we might want to call them. And within those realms, there are different effects that might be then started to be seen by yourselves from your own perspective. So as you rise through the third dimension, you start to increase up, and then it starts you to have the availability to, starts you to then have the availability to tap into a different bandwidth, which is more of a width rather than a height, if we could imagine. And the width of it, then we start to then sort of tap into different dimensions of spirit realms, when we start to bring in our psychic abilities, our mediumship, and all those beautiful sort of things that start to come online. Our awareness widens into that greater knowing of seeing things past the five senses. So as we move into that, then we're starting to tap into the fourth dimensions, because that's where spirit realm is. It's in the fourth dimension. It's in that energetic field. And then within it, then you might also then go into what we call the lower fourth. And it is a rite of passage that way through, where it sparks and inspires us to look at our shadow. And this is where the dark night of the soul comes in, as we start to tap into the denser aspects of ourselves. And the denser aspects of ourselves start to come online. It's a multi-dimensional aspect integration that is seen through the perception of the eye, of what we might call entity attachment. And as these entities come in and show themselves as being, these might be outward infiltrations, or it might be that it's actually us waking up to our lower realms of being. So like multi-dimensional aspects, you might have a Palladian multi-dimensional aspects, which is of a higher vibration of the light. You also, within that realm, start to actually get to see your dark entity of self. Now, these dark entities of self might be restrictive energy, and that, and yourself might want to restrict you from the heights of growth into the light and hold you and anchor you down into the third dimension, to anchor you down into which you are not. So perceived ideas of entity attachments and demonic degrees of, you know, of outward sources actually could be that it is an aspect of yourself that is lost within the fourth dimension that anchors you down into third. It can also be that it's an infiltration of your light that is from an outward source. I might have somebody deliver something in a minute, so if I do, then I'll switch off. So as we sort of move through this sticky patch of information that we're starting to access and download into our system, we need to sort of be aware that the anchoring into those aspects of ourselves may then affect our energetic flow and keep us trapped, or perceived to be trapped, within that realm of being. So as we open up into those realms, we need to be aware of that progression of our spirituality into the heights of who we are, and move through that sticky field of energy and release the dense aspects of ourselves, so that we can then gain access and download all that beautiful stuff that we hold as being high vibration, that of the light. Alla gianta darissimo kosh makiatan, esiankia tutta ba'asia bakiatan. This is, if this is bringing in a little bit of fear, don't worry about it, it's showing you. So the universe will show you what you're holding that is restricting you from your growth. So you don't need to unpack and pick it. It's just to see it as a formulation of our rise, is that we need to go through these rites of passages to actually take us into the realms of a greater knowing of who we are, and to the remembrance of our light. Thank you. So if you could imagine that yourself, like you're a rocket and you're going through a sticky patch of space, which is quite dense. As you go through this sticky patch of reality here, you're moving from third dimension and increasing in your vibration, but you're hitting and going through this sticky patch. It's like a spider's web into a degree, if you could imagine that you're a little fly going into a web of light that holds a stickiness, and a spider within it will move quite freely, but the fly hitting that field of energy cannot necessarily get through it. If you don't land a pin upon that sticky patch, then you're just going to go through there quite easily. As you raise in your vibration, you'll be able to actually move through it with ease. You have a sovereignty of light patterning, a template of being. You're fortifying your light, and as you move through it, there's nothing that can affect you as you move through that field of energy. But if something's attracting you to it, maybe it's yourself attracting you to you, or something that's entwining you into that field of energy, then that field of energy will keep you in a perpetuating cycle and pattern. So we move through from the 3D dimension up through in our frequencies. We hit a bandwidth, we move through that, and it can be quite traumatic through the experience from a human perspective. And then as we move through, you might have a little bit of a sticky patch experience. And then with that, then you then start to rise through the fourth, moving through to the fifth, and then upwards and out through these dimensions, which is levels of consciousness. These are not physical realms as such. These are levels of awareness of self. So the level of awareness of yourself as you're rising through into the lower fourth, you will hit a shadow. The shadow will be shown to you in whatever way that may be. Now, I actually spoke to a lady yesterday that was sticky patchy for 25 years. I went through sticky patchy for about a month or so when I was going through it. It was an experience that was really quite traumatic. And many, many people have these experiences to get to see this is actually in a reality complex in itself. Some people may actually rise up but get entwined within the light of the lower fourth and only see the light within it, and that it keeps you in a sustainable, that's not the word, like a controlled set of awakening, and you don't push yourself through. So you might get into mediumship and psychic abilities, but you don't go any further than that. You're quite happy and comfortable, and that's the individual soul's journey. But the movement into the rise, into the upper fourth, into fifth, the movement of that then will actually give you more freedom to experience more galactic types and celestial types of experiences, and the deepening of awareness of who you are, moving out of mind and knowledge of other people's perception of what spirituality is, or maybe a sticky patch of religion or love and light brigade or whatever it may be. This controlled rise is here for the many. So if we go into a bit of conspiracy here, is that the controlled love and light is apparent, that many of the controllers, if we could say, would be controlling our spirituality at this point here, and only enabling us to sort of perceive that we are rising when we can go far beyond this. The place of empowerment moves through that fourth dimension and up into the upper fourth to the fifth. And this is where more freedom rises and comes into. And we find that the people that have been on their spiritual journey for a very long time and are stuck in love and light won't want to look at their shadow. So therefore they will be just in that little cycle within that experience, and that's a soul's choice and learning. But if you're there and you want to push through that sticky patch, then you'll need to look through into that shadow work as you rise into the upper fourth. Alla chianto de basio mo kosh macchiata, e la chianto de basio mo kosh macchiata di sia macchiatam. If you think that this reality is absolutely amazing, and which it is, then this reality is absolutely amazing, and this one is amazing, It is as you rise up through it, everything starts to be seen from a different perspective, and your reality as you rise into your light will become more blissful because there's less shadow to deal with. And we will morph and change as we move and go up and in between all of this. We're not just going up and that's it and that's where we stay. We move up and out and through and entwine ourselves within these realities, depending on where we're at in our now moment and how we bump a car against each other. And as we sort of shift between it, we might then come up and back down, but up and down, up and down, up and down, with people mirroring experiences in our direction, which are beautiful gifts after all. So I'm going to continue this video onto my Patreon and onto my YouTube membership to sort of like look at ways that we can move through this process at a quickened pace rather than getting entwined within it. But the information for this video today, for you guys, beautiful guys, that my subscribers and followers and people that have just come by me by chance, is I'm just going to leave it there for now. and probably revisit this particular subject as cycles come and go, and we start to learn and refine our understanding of it as we rise in downloading more and more information as we go. So I thank you very much for coming into my YouTube channel, and I invite you to go and have a look at different playlists and information that I've done from my past, and you'll see that I've morphed and changed throughout with different backdrops, but Buddha's still with me here. So please leave your comments and let me know what you think on this particular subject. I really don't want you to go interfere with any of it. Just see it as it is, and it's a game to be played. The more that you can see it as that, the easier it is to navigate the whole thing. So just keep it going, witness it, rise, let things go, see what's presented, and you will shine even more and even more brighter at that. May you start to remember with all that you are this most beautiful, beautiful, shining bright star. So from me, Nicola Light, I wish you well on your journey. So, continuing this video, the full version of the video here on Patreon and on my membership, I just wanted to go into a little bit more.